a lot of swirling. The coaching search rages on. Obviously, South kind of moving on from Will Muschamp. And I more so want to get your take on, you know, Shane Beamer is one of the names that's very popular right now. And Shane, the guy that was at South Carolina when you were there. And so I'm sure you know him very, very well. But he is a guy that is a very popular name right now. And like we were talking a little bit off air, you know, when you're getting the endorsements he's getting from Marcus Lattimore, DJ Swearinger, Melvin Ingram, Devontae Holloman, Pat DeMarco, Stephen Garcia. I mean, the names just keep going down. Some of the best to ever wear the garnet and black. It's hard to ignore. But I want to ask you about your thoughts on Shane Beamer, just as a person, as a coach, what you remember from him. And also just ask you, you know, I'm not sure how much Gamecock football you watch now or have watched recently, but are there any specific things that you want to see from the next football coach? Because I've had a lot of your former teammates on, some of the best Gamecocks ever. You know, the interview I did with DJ Swearinger was very well publicized. And, you know, him talking about he feels like the standard has been lost. And you know, multiple guys have said that. So, again, I want to get your takes on Shane Beamer. And then also, are there any specifics that come to your mind, things you want to see, the qualities in the next Gamecocks head football coach?
You know, I can't speak on Muschamp too much because I don't know too much about Muschamp. I don't know what qualities he possessed. I met him one time when I went up there to the facility. Beamer, love Beamer. Beamer's a great dude, great coach. He didn't coach me personally. He was a special team coach and on the defensive side. So I really didn't have a huge contact with him, but his energy. That's what it's all about, his energy. That energy is amazing. That going and high-fiving and dapping up and jumping in the air, that's what it is these days. Mm. You know, that's what it is these days. So for me as a next head coach, I would love to see somebody who's enthusiastic, who's ready to – who is – guys, these days, guys are not responding to the yelling. You got to have a different outlet. Guys are not responding. Like when I was playing, you could grab my face mask. Coach Nick would grab my face mask, shake my face mask, spitting in my face with his sticky breath, yelling and screaming at me. And I want to fight him, but I accept it. And I play ball. You know, nowadays, kids going to transfer. He's going to leave school. Yeah. He's going to transfer to another school. Like, they don't like me here. Like, I'm going to get out of here. So that's not necessarily the route that you go, you know. You know, you want to try to get qualities of these coaches that are winning, that are doing it, that are having success. You know, look at Dabo Swinney. I remember when Dabo first got there, you know, he's freaking dancing in the middle, freaking dapping. Like, that creates an environment where kids see this. You're selling the program to 17-year-olds, 16-year-olds, 15-year-olds. You're selling the program to them. 18-year-olds, you're selling the program to them. And you sell a program by having fun. Enjoyment. The coach, like, damn, I want to go play for that coach. Like, he turned up. Like, yeah. Like, I love his energy. You know what I mean? So, like, when you playing, when you doing it and expressing it, that's I think is a big thing. And we need somebody who's for the players. You know, who is there to not only see you. I'm not saying that Muschamp didn't do any of this because, like I said, I don't know what Muschamp had going on up there. I do not know because I wasn't there. I haven't been talking to people, but I just know that the qualities of a coach, somebody who's energetic, somebody whose brain is that fire, that passion, someone who loves the kids and loves the game, you know, that's big because kids see that. You know, kids gonna see if you're a phony or not. You know, you can't go to the hood and try to get this five-star kid that's growing up in the hood and you coming in there being a phony. You know, when you got somebody like Alabama coming in there presenting, hey, we can get you to the NFL, Clemson, we're going to get you there, we're going to play in the biggest game, biggest lights. You got to sell something different.
Yeah.
Because that's not where we're at as a program. So you have to sell, you have to be able to sell basically yourself as a coach in the environment that you're going to be coming in because you're not selling, you're not going to be able to sell, hey, we're going to play in the national title game this year, we're going to be in the top four rankings, like you're going to be playing in big, front of big crowds, but you're not going to be able to sell that. That's not our selling point. So the coach has to be the selling point. The coach has to be somebody that players will want to come play for, that players will want to compete at the highest level for because they like, damn, I love this guy. This is a guy. You want a coach that after you leave, you still feel comfortable to be like, to pull up, you know, to contact. You know, that's the type of stuff. I still talk to Coach Elliott. I wanted to perform for Coach Elliott. Mm. I wanted to. I didn't want Coach Elliott to. I didn't want myself to look bad, but I know Coach Elliott would. He would come. We would be in full pads, and Coach Elliott would be down there in the middle getting beat up by me and Rakitis. Me and Rakitis, we'd be like, we finna smoke Coach today. He want to jump in the bed. He want to jump with us. We finna bang him. He would just, but that would rub off on us. You know, we would go, he would make us go up and present the game plan, you know, in the meeting rooms. And that stuff would rub off on us. You want to go out and play for a guy like that. You know what I'm saying? Coach Spurrier, he spoke for himself. You know, he already had the resume. You know, that's the reason, main reason why I went, because Kenny and Coach Spurrier, like, damn, you want to play for the all-ball coach, the gunslinging ball coach. He's a big-time winning ball coach. You want to do that, you know? So, to me, to turn the program around, you have to get a coach that can sell himself. And the way that he sells himself is by being enthusiastic, because you're not selling the – you can't sell the program right now. Right. I mean, it's not a, you can't be like, yeah, we're going to, you know, we're 2-7
right now, yeah.
2-7, yeah. You're not going to go into somebody's house this offseason and talk about the 2-7 football season and coming to this program to change it around. Like, no, you're going to talk about yourself as a coach and what you're presenting and how you feel like you can come and help me as a coach change this program around. And that's why I feel like the coach is an enthusiastic coach, an energetic coach, a coach that is for the players would be a perfect fit. You know, somebody who's going to have a good time, somebody who's going to do those cookouts, somebody who's going to, you know, just put those things together. Coach Brad might not have came to a cookout, but he would tell me to throw a cookout, you know? Like Coach Ellen would tell me to throw a cookout. He would tell me those things. They would endorse Fitzgerald. He would, our strength coach, he would endorse those things. He would get us a cooler and bring drink, not alcoholic drinks, but like freaking juices and, you know, sodas and stuff like that and just drop them off and leave. You know, like those are the types of things that make teams better. You know, so when you got coaches, I'm not saying, I don't know if they was doing that on that team. I don't know. I can't say. Like I said, I didn't talk to that team, but I know for a fact that those things like that will, you know, make things a lot better.